In about 10 minutes, your Facebook business page will be up and running. Just follow the steps in this video. Let's dive in right now. Go to facebook.com. In here, you might already be logged in. If not, no problem. Go over here and press create a page for celebrity, brand, or business. Then we need to log in with our Facebook credentials. If you don't have it yet, then you can press this button, sign up. Don't worry if your coworkers need to actually work also on the Facebook page. Fill in your credentials and press on login. And here we are now at the Facebook create a page page. The first thing we need to do is go on the left side over there to add in our page name. This will be our brand name, for example. For this tutorial, I'm going to create a page about a company that does not exist, Water Slide Inc. After that, we go to category in here, click on it and start typing to find your category. In our example, we go with construction company, engineering servers, or maybe I am a structural engineer, coach, police station, brokerage firm. Once you have added in one category, you can always add in more categories. For example, I do want to have the water park in there. After you add in the categories, we go to the bio. In here, you can type in 100 characters, which will describe your page. In our case, I'm gonna add in this. And don't worry, you can always change it later on. After you've added in the title, the category, and the bio, we press over here on create page. Well done. Now we're going to add in more details to help people find our page, connect with us, and find more information about your business. The first thing, of course, is our website. Let's add it in over there. Then we go to the phone number, on which phone number people can actually reach you. And after that, we're gonna add in an email. Then we're gonna add in your address. After that, we scroll a little bit down and we're gonna add in our hours. Then we have three options available for your business. No hours available, so we don't show any hours on the Facebook page. We are always open 24 hours a day, or we are open at selected hours. When you click on this one, we get the select hours box, and here we can change all the hours per day. This might be useful. Add in just what you want, for example, from 8 a.m. until, well, we are open till 7. If you want to add it in for every single day, it's all the same. You can actually just do something else. Just copy this one, copy, go over here and paste it. Also there, paste it, paste it, paste it. Here we go. Then on closing, just copy this one, go over there and press paste, and do this with every single time. Now, if you're not open on Saturday and Sunday, you can just delete that one, and then you are closed in the weekends and only open during the weekdays. When you have filled in all the hours you want, we press on save. Well, now we're getting very close, press next. And then it's time to customize our page with a beautiful profile picture and a cover photo. Now, you can see that your page profile pictures will be this size on your computers and 169 on smartphones and 36 by 36 on most feature phones. What do you learn of this? Make sure that it's a square. It doesn't matter if it's bigger, Facebook will resize it anyway. Add in your logo over there. You can add any picture in there, but I recommend it to make it square so it can be fit in this beautiful circle. And then we're gonna add in a cover photo over there. And then you can drag it whatever you want to fit on your screen. So we want to have it like this. And that makes you wonder, what are the perfect sizes for the Facebook cover page? Cover photo, it should left align with a full bleed and a 69 aspect ratio. Make sure that it's at least 400 wide and 150 pixels tall. If it's bigger, it's okay, Facebook just will resize it. I like this very much as we are constructing water slides, and I don't like the quality of this picture, but hey, who cares? After that, we click on add action button. Now here you can choose what kind of engagement you want from your Facebook visitors. Let's press try it. There are a lot of different things we can do with this button. You can press book now, sign up, start your order, if you're a restaurant, view shop, get your tickets, send a message, send WhatsApp message, or call now. Just choose the one that you want this action button to do on your page. On this page, we want people to send a WhatsApp message. Make sure to select the right country over there, and after that type in the phone number or your WhatsApp business number. After that, we need to press on send code because this number needs to be verified by Facebook. Then you have received a WhatsApp message with your confirmation code, so fill it in over there and press save. But maybe you don't want to send in a WhatsApp message. You can also choose, for example, to do a phone call. Press next. Then you just enter in your phone number in here. And now after that, we press save. Once you're done with your action button, press on next. Then Facebook will ask you if you want to add in WhatsApp to your page. Anyway, you can press on skip if your business doesn't have this. If you do have this, then you select the right country, add in your WhatsApp phone number, press get code, and then you will see a confirmation message on your WhatsApp, which you can fill in over there. For now, we're gonna press skip. Then we can invite our current friends on Facebook to our newly created page. You can press invite friends. Then you have a daily invite limit of 1,000 people each day. So if you have more than 1,000 friends, then you can press on here, select all 1,000 of 1,208. And then you can press send invites and they will get a personal invite of your current page. After you've sent the invites, you can close this box and you can press on next. Then we can turn on notifications on your profile. So when you're using Facebook on your personal account, you will get notification about your business page. I think you want to keep this on as it is very useful, but in some cases you might want to turn it off. There's also a way to get more marketing and promotional emails about your Facebook page. If you enable this one, you get some emails from Facebook, which tells you how to get more out of your page and especially how to advertise your page on Facebook. Press done. Well done, now your new page is live. Facebook also tells you now that you have switched from your profile to your page. Very important, keep that in mind when visiting Facebook on which profile or page you're on. Here we can do take a tour or press not now. If you want to switch back to your personal profile, you go over here in the corner and then you can switch from your page to your personal profile in there. That easy, make sure to check this when visiting Facebook. You don't want the two to get mixed up. The business model of Facebook is of course advertising and promoting on their platform. That's why you can see the ad center over here, create ads, promote, and again, the promote. So what you now need to do is of course to go over here and add in some posts and some new things to show with your audience. Remember always, why do people want to follow your Facebook page? It has to be really interesting, the things you're sharing on your Facebook brand page. Now, if you want to change these things again, like your profile picture, just click on this camera icon over there and then you can change your thumbnail. Or you can go over here and click on the cover photo, edit it right there, and you can change it or upload it or reposition it, remove it. But there's also a manage button and a edit button. Let's go to manage first. And here we are now at your professional dashboard. On the overview, you can see your post reach, your post engagement, your new likes, recent content, recent messages, everything in here to actually control your page and see how it works. In here, you can go to your home insight. You will see your followers. Again, the post reach the best post of your page, your content, your audience. When you have at least 100 followers, you will see more about their geography, where they are, if they're female or male, the ages, everything about your page. If you go to your page again, you can see your reach, your engagement, your likes, your followers, everything you want to know about your Facebook page. In the content tab, you can create a post and of course create more ads. You can see your audience if you have at least 100 followers. You can create ads for your brand. You can invite friends. And you have a lot more things to see in here. You can earn achievements. You have the inspiration hub. You can go to the comments manager, which you can control the comments and respond on them. You can create events over there so you can push them and advertise them to more people. And then in page access, and this is the first thing you might want to change to add some coworkers who can also moderate your Facebook business page. If you press on add new, you can invite someone so they can control the Facebook page also. If you want to do this, just press on next and just add in an email address or the name of the person you want to add. Just add in the name or the email address of the person you want to have full control over your Facebook business page. In my case, of course, Ferdy. Let's add it in and invite him to join our page. But maybe you don't want to give Ferdy full control of your Facebook business page. You just go to a community manager and just press manage. Then we're just gonna add in a new community manager. Click on it and again, get started. And then we're gonna add in a name or mail and just click on it. And then we're gonna press send invite. And then they get the invite and go control your Facebook business page. Another real cool new feature is the A/B testing. In here, you can test the best video postings of your business page. That's kind of neat. So you just press create A/B test, just add in a video of version A and add in a video version B. Maybe you have three versions of your video. So you're gonna add in a new version, add them all in, create the post, put it out there, and let Facebook determine which one get the best engagement. And then we also have over here a moderation assist. If you get a lot of comments and messages and questions through your Facebook business page, this thing will help you set out what will be published and what will be blocked. And you can also change your messaging settings. You can also link account with WhatsApp and Facebook and Instagram. Really great. But you might also have business apps, third-party apps, all kind of apps with your Facebook business page. You can just type it in here. For example, I want to connect it with HubSpot, or I want to connect it with Soho CRM conversions or ActiveCampaign. It's all in here. They have an extremely big database of apps to connect your Facebook business page. The list goes on and on and on and on and never stops. So just type it in, search for it, and then connect it. And then we have over here the page recommendations. In here, Facebook will advise you to grow your audience within Facebook. Really useful. Now it's up to you to grow your Facebook business page to get more audience, less people engage with your brand, answer questions, and all kind of those things. If you have any questions or just want to say thank you, Matt, drop it down in the comments. I'll always reply. Hit that like button if I helped you out and subscribe over there because I have a lot more viewers than actual subscribers. After that, check out this video, which has nothing to do with Facebook. I think.